सेकेंड ईयर इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टाइम इन योर MBBS. द सब्जेक्ट्स दैट यू स्टडी इन दिस ईयर विल फॉर्म द बेसिस फॉर योर फाइनल ईयर सब्जेक्ट्स टू. एंड गाइज, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डू वेल इन द नेक्स्ट एग्जाम, यू हैव टू डू वेल इन द सेकेंड ईयर. एंड इफ यू आर समवन हु वॉन्ट्स टू डू वेल इन द सेकेंड ईयर, गाइज, दिस वीडियो इज मेड फॉर यू. हे गाइज, आई एम डॉक्टर हिमांशु गुप्ता एंड आई हैड सिक्योर्ड अ रैंक ऑफ 62 इन नीट PG 2018. So for the past 3 years, I have been guiding students to help them get a good rank in AIIMS, PGI and NEET PG. So guys, today in this video, I'm going to discuss with you why do you need to study well during your second year MBBS and how you will plan your day, how you will plan your year, how you will study the standard textbooks and which standard textbooks you need to study and how you will utilize online platforms like Maru for your preparation. So guys, शुरू करते हैं. सो लेट अस हैव अ लुक व्हाट इज दैट मिस्टेक दैट मेनी स्टूडेंट्स कमिट ड्यूरिंग द MBBS. MBBS इज अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम. द प्रॉब्लम दैट हैपन्स विद अस इज दैट वी लूज ट्रैक ऑफ आवर गोल्स. द रिवॉर्ड ऑफ बिकमिंग अ डॉक्टर इज टू फार एंड सो वी डोंट फील लाइक स्टडिंग इन द प्रेजेंट एंड वी फील लाइक डूइंग अदर थिंग्स. सो गाइज, आई वॉन्ट टू स्केयर यू नाउ एट दिस मोमेंट ओनली सो दैट यू डोंट डू दिस मिस्टेक. You know what will happen if you will not study well? There are students who drop after the MBBS for so many years just because they didn't study well during the MBBS. There are so many students who fail in the various prof exams because they do not study well in the MBBS. And you must have seen in your first year as well, there will be some students who have failed just because they did not study well during the first year MBBS. And guys, it doesn't matter if you have failed, okay? You have the time now, okay? You have the time to correct your mistakes. And I can tell you that if you devote at least 2 to 3 hours daily for your studies, you have the chance to be in a great college during your post-graduation. Even if you are in a private medical college right now, even if you are a foreign medical graduate, okay? You have the chance to be in the topmost colleges by studying in the present. So guys, don't waste this time. I am telling you that you don't need to study much. You just need to study 2 to 3 hours daily. And guys, slowly and slowly you will see that these 2 to 3 hours in a period of 4.5 years, they will matter a lot. Now guys, coming to the question, how you will start studying? Because I have got a lot many requests from the students, sir, I have not done well during the first year MBBS and now I want to do well in the next exam. So how can I start? So guys, I will tell you this beautiful principle, that is a 10 minute rule. You have to start studying by just 10 minutes every day. You will take out 10 minutes every day from your routine to go to the library, or if you are just sitting in your room and studying, you will do that. And you will see that in a matter of 3 months, from 10 minutes you are studying to 3 hours daily. So nothing big has to be done. You just have to do this small task of studying 10 minutes daily. Now, second thing that you will do is that you will plan your everyday. Okay? Because I will tell you one important quote. Proper planning prevents poor performance. You know, after planning your day, you guys will not be confused. Because what happens with many students is that they don't know what they have to study that day. If you just take out 5 minutes from your routine, 5 minutes from your day in the night or in the morning, just try to think that what are the 3 topics, the 3 MIT principle, the 3 most important topics that you will read today. If you are covering 3 important topics every day, you will see that in a matter of 360 days, you are covering more than 1,000 important topics. And if you cover more than 1,000 important topics very well, there is no chance that you cannot do well. There is no chance that you will not perform well in the next exam. So guys, you will take out 10 minutes every day and you will plan what you will study that day. And third point that I want to tell you is that 90-90 principle. So guys, once you have overcome that barrier of studying 10 minutes every day, I would like you to follow this 90-90 rule. And what is this 90-90 rule? You know what happens with many students? They will go to the college and after coming back from the college, you know, they will sleep. they will watch Netflix. Even if you are going for online classes, you know what happens. After watching classes for 6 hours, you don't feel like doing anything. So this is one mistake that you won't do. So coming to the 90-90 principle. So guys, this 90-90 principle for students states that after coming back from the college, the first 90 minutes that you spend will be on the most productive task. And for you guys, the most productive task is studying. So guys, after completing your lectures, okay, you will devote at least 90 minutes to your studies. And if you do that continuously for 90 days, guys, your productivity will shoot up. Your marks in the class test will shoot up. Your score in the main exam will shoot up. So guys, just remember these three principles. That is the 10-minute rule, the 90-90 rule, and the third is you will plan your everyday. Now guys, coming to the question, which books you have to read in the second year MBBS. So guys, for pathology, the Robbins is a must read book. You have to read your Robbins cover to cover, and I can tell you that if you do Robbins very well, okay, you will definitely become a very good doctor. Then for pharmacology, you can follow KDT. For microbiology, either you can follow Anant Narayan or you can follow Surinder Sir's book. So these are very good books. And if you want to know how you have to study these standard textbooks, I have made a video specifically on that topic, how you have to read a standard textbook. So you can always check that out. Then guys, I want to give you the target, how many times you have to complete these standard textbooks. So what I have seen, you know, the toppers usually complete their standard textbooks at least 4 to 5 times. So this should be your target, that every book you have to do at least 4 to 5 times. Now you must be scared ki yaar 4 to 5 times kaise padhenge, hai na? 4 to 5 times padhne ke liye you don't have to devote a lot of time. What you have to do, you have to just start from studying 10 pages a day, 5 pages a day. Okay, even if you study 5 to 10 pages every day, in a matter of year you are studying more than 3600 pages. So this is the magic of being consistent, of being persistent in your effort. So just start from 5 pages. Don't be scared that you have to do such big books. Slowly and slowly you will see that all your study material can be covered in this much time, if you are being consistent, if you are persistent in your efforts. And now guys, coming to the online courses that you can go for. So guys, it's always a great idea to utilize the online videos along with your standard textbooks. So that will help you to read your standard textbooks, as well as it will help you to retain your topics for a longer period of time. And guys, an extra tip that I want to give you here is that, you know, many students, they start preparing their final year subjects in the second year itself. And if you start preparing these final year subjects on your own, it will be tough. And so for that, you can utilize the online videos that are available. The second thing that I want from you is that, you know, utilize the QBank that is given in these online apps. So what will happen, you know, you will read a chapter and you will try to actively recall that chapter by solving the QBank of that chapter. So that will help you retain things for a longer period of time. Coming to which online app I should go for. So guys, I want to tell you that every institute and every teacher works really hard for their students, and there are minor differences here and there between each app. So if you are following one institute, just stick to that. Don't worry that you are missing out on something by not joining the other institute. But still, if you are confused and if you want my opinion, I would advise you that you can go for Marrow. So what are the cool features that are like in Marrow? So guys, one feature that I really like is, you know, in the video section, they have provided the timestamping for every chapter, for every topic. So if you are reading one topic from the standard textbook and if you are finding that topic really tough, so you can directly jump onto that topic from that video by clicking onto the timestamp that has been provided. And guys, Shivika ma'am, Ila Jain ma'am and Ranjan sir will not only help you clear the next exam, but also they will make your life simpler for the prof exams as well. And you know, Ranjan sir will use a lot of mnemonics during his class, and he will make pharmacology a very easy subject to remember. And you know, the question bank also that has been provided in the Marrow, it has been provided for each and every chapter. So guys, once you have done a chapter from your standard textbook, so you can solve the MCQs of that chapter from the Marrow QBank. And you know that you can do like after a gap of 2 to 3 days, and so this will help you retain that chapter for a longer period of time. At last guys, I want to tell you that it is your own hard work, your own consistency and persistence that will propel you forward in your life. And before you leave, I want you to watch this 2-minute rule in which I discuss how you can overcome your procrastination. And guys, if you want to hear more from me, do subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you get notification as soon as I post my next video. So guys, bye bye and see you in the next video.